Well, we've been talking about power line problems, and power line problems are keeping many Iowans to our west in the dark.
Carroll County especially hard hit by the power outages caused by yesterday's ice storm. News Channel 8's Carrie Gavin joins us now live via Newstar 8 satellite from Carroll with more on this story. Carrie?
Well, good afternoon, Marcus and Molly. You know, on our way up here, it wasn't too bad, but it seemed like the second that we crossed into Carroll County, you could just see how the ice had blanketed the county. Here's an example of what these power lines here look like. Check out this ice. It's from this tree behind me, but it's about 3/4 to maybe an inch in some areas. That's what most of the power lines look like here. Now, this is what it looked like when we arrived in Carroll. Obviously, we started to see down power lines along the way, but when we actually got into Carroll, the Hy-Vee seemed to be like a gathering station, a dispatch area for power companies from all over the Midwest that have come here to help. There were dozens and dozens of power companies and workers here trying to figure out how they're going to get power restored to nearly some 5,000 residents in Carroll. That's an estimate of how many people are without power here. The Red Cross has set up three different shelters. Two of them remain open right now, but actually it is Bradere that seemed to be the worst right now, with most of its 500 residents without power. Now, as you can see, it's the power lines, the transformers, as my photographer Mike Sims is showing you, on how bad this ice is, anywhere from a 3/4 of an inch to an inch. A lot of the trees in the area, if they're not bent over, hug over, slumped to the ground, their limbs are actually broken across the way. You might be able to see some limbs broken off of the trees in many, many parts of Carroll County's. This is the site. And actually, the ice that you see on these limbs of the trees, they seem to fall off onto the ground and create almost like a cluster on the ground. So while the main roads are pretty clear, there's these clusters of ice that are forming somewhat like this that would then meld together in the street, and they are just creating an ice skating rink on all those roads that are not major. So we'll be in Carroll for most of the day today, and we'll bring you more at 5 and 6 tonight. Now, Molly and Marcus, back to you.
Carrie, you mentioned some 5,000 people in Carroll right now without power. Any estimates as to when those people will get back online?
Well, with all those power crews that they brought in from various different states, they're hoping to do it as soon as possible, but they're saying it could take anywhere from 5 days to 7 days, because that's just how bad the ice damage is.
All right, Carrie Gavin, thank you very much. And, of course, as you mentioned, much more coming up at 5 and 6.